Hey everybody, and welcome back. So this week we have something that disappeared for a while and came back in its racist glory. I'm talking, of course, about the spectacle that we like to call Black Hitler. Now, if you don't know who I'm talking about, this is some asshole who thinks that black people can't be racist.
Okay, first and foremost, we can't be racist. Black people do not have a system of race to be racist off of. We are not colonizers. We are the colonized. So any hatred or dismissal or anger that we feel towards our oppressor is just a reaction of their action.
He says that white people aren't allowed to adopt black children.
Video. White people, come here. Stop adopting black children. Okay, this child clearly wants to be white. Okay.
Thinks that white people adopting black children is a kidnapping.
This kidnapping, I mean adoption. Then here they come to scoop up our children and those kidnapped black children, I mean adopted black children.
He tried to excuse the kids that committed that Chicago kidnapping earlier this year just because the four kids were black and the victim was white.
Jesse, have you heard some of my people kidnapped one of your people, put him in a tub and beat him up a little bit? You know, they scraped him up a little bit, tied him, went on live stream and stuff about it. Have you heard about it?
I did. I heard about it.
Crazy, right? But actually, it's not so crazy since, you know, your people built an entire capitalist, imperialist society on top of my people. You know, you want to talk about kidnapping and torture. Can we talk about the almost 700 years of kidnapping and torture of African people? The reason why I'm here speaking English in this fluent white girl tongue right now, okay? So this whole moral equivalency that the colonial media, when I say colonial media, I mean cracker media, white media, imperialist media, white power media, capitalist
media,
that's what we're talking about, right, Jesse?
Yes.
And tell the people why is the colonized people and the colonizer people not equal in this situation? Because what they're trying to depict is these four African teenagers are just bad, horrible people, and this innocent white man, there's no such thing as an innocent white man. Jesse, can you tell that to the people?
Now, he tries to convince us that black people can't be racist. However, this entire channel is proof of the opposite. Now, I have never given two shits about race. I follow YouTubers of a whole bunch of different races. I follow YouTubers with a whole bunch of different backgrounds. Some of my favorite actors, actresses, singers, and what have you are of different races. I've never once cared about skin color in anything. Like Martin Luther King said, I judge people by the content of their character, not the color of their skin. Now, as far as the content of character, Gazi Kodzo is a piece of shit. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. I can't stand this motherfucker. And I will show you a video that he released recently that is another example as to why I can't fucking stand him.
Aquavia, y'all, it's me, Gazi, and yes, white power got me deleted on Twitter.
No, motherfucker. You got yourself deleted off of Twitter because of the racist bullshit that you were spreading on there.
Don't worry, as long as you like this Facebook page, you will get new videos and new posts of me all the time, okay?
Hey, Facebook. Y'all deleted Upchurch's videos off of Facebook because of harmful content or whatever. Are you guys gonna do the same thing to this racist?
Until I come out with my new app. Aha! Anyways, I was watching this video of Maisha Johnson, who is the widower and the wife of LaDavid Johnson, one of the soldiers that was sent back from the country of Niger to America via a box. And Donald Trump called her and did not know her husband's name, which really hurt Maisha and had her crying. And he also said to Maisha, your husband knew what he signed up for, and he went anyways, which really hurt her and has me asking a real question. White America, do black soldiers really know what we sign up for when we join your military?
Okay, first off, to Sergeant LaDavid Johnson, I thank you for your service, and may God rest your soul. I also offer my deepest condolences to the family of this brave young man. And to you, Black Hitler, I'm not going to defend Donald Trump's call to the widow. He could have done a way better job. However, you are 10 times the asshole that Donald Trump is, because you're using the death of this soldier and the pain of this young lady to forward your black supremacist bullshit. So fuck you.
Military? Okay, I do not think so, because a lot less of us would be in that imperialist, white power, white nationalist military. Okay, so if you know a black soldier, make sure to tag them and share this video to them so I can tell them the truth.
Motherfucker, you wouldn't know the truth if it chained your ass up, sold you to the highest bidder, then shipped you across the ocean to another country to pick cotton.
Wow!
Okay, that was actually kind of racist. Lord, I apologize.
And, Lord, I apologize for that third.
But seriously, imperialistic, white nationalist military? Citation needed, asshole.
Of what kind of military and power and system and status quo they're fighting for, okay? Because I doubt that Mr. Johnson knew that he fought in the same military that raped, killed, and poured acid on the genitals of Lavina Johnson, a 19-year-old black woman who joined the military, and then they lied and called it suicide, okay?
Okay, what happened to that young lady is tragic, and there's no excuse for it. But that does not prove that we have a white nationalist, racist military, or whatever the hell you're claiming.
The disrespect, Maisha, isn't not knowing your husband's name by this white nationalist, disgusting, Dorito-colored President Donald Trump. The disrespect started 600 years ago when white power attacked Africa and colonized African people and forced us into slavery.
Actually, no, Black Hitler. The disrespect comes from you, who's using the death of this brave soldier to push your black supremacist bullshit. And the fact that you have your head planted so firmly up your ass that you can't see that it is not 600 years ago. You were never a slave, and nobody alive in this country today was ever a slave. And if you'd pull your head out of your ass for a few seconds, maybe you could read a history book and learn that it was other black people that sold black people into slavery.
Made us build an economic system which we know as capitalism today, which gave birth to these nations as America and the rest of them, okay?
Okay, let's look here. You're wearing a camouflage jacket. You're wearing other articles of clothing. You're recording this on a phone or a camera. You probably have a computer of which you're using to edit and upload this video. You have a roof over your head. You were uploading this video to a platform that was created via capitalism. Now, you love to argue that capitalism is benefiting off of the backs of African people. Now, for sake of argument, let's pretend that's true. By extension, you are benefiting off of the backs of African people. Therefore, you, my friend, are a fucking hypocrite.
Them, okay? The disrespect is imprisoning millions of African people around the world. The disrespect is pushing police into our communities to murder us, murder our children, and abuse us and rape us every day.
Little logic for you here, bud. Number one, if you don't commit a crime, you don't go to prison. And that's not a racially discriminating thing. Nobody has to go to prison. Just don't commit crimes. Now, as far as your little police going into our neighborhoods bullshit, that doesn't fucking happen either. You're just fear-mongering and trying to turn people against the police.
That is where the disrespect is. The real disrespect is forcing us into poverty, which puts us in an economic system for us to even think to want to join the military just to get some alleviation from being poor. And then they ship us to Africa, where they stole us from, just to kill our own brothers and sisters to make white power richer and black people all around the world poorer. All of this to sustain white power imperialism. All of this to keep capitalism going through imperialism, so whites can continue to be richer and African people around the world can continue to be poorer.
Oh, for fuck's sake, you dumb conspiracy theorist. Alex Jones couldn't come up with something that stupid.
They say, oh, they're fighting for freedom. He fought for freedom. Stop lying to Maisha. Stop lying to African people who signed up for the military. They're not fighting for freedom.
Stop lying to Maisha. Stop lying to African people. Stop telling everybody that white people wake up in the morning and try to figure out how they feel like oppressing black people that day.
Did he die trying to get George Zimmerman? Did he die trying to get Darren Wilson? Did he die trying to get some of these murderous pigs and white nationalists that are killing black people and black children? Fighting for freedom?
No, they were down in Niger fighting terrorism. You're one of those fuckheads that's under the impression that a black man is innocent just because he's black and didn't deserve to get shot, when in reality, no matter what race you are, if you don't comply with police orders and you threaten that police officer's life or make them feel in danger, you're gonna get shot. Follow orders. It's that simple.
Did they go to Niger to stop police murder? Because that's what fighting for freedom looks like to black people.
No, you just want freedom from the police and freedom from the law and to be handed free shit. That's not freedom for black people. That's freedom for pieces of shit, criminals, and thugs that don't want to actually make something of themselves, regardless of what race you are. Black people got the freedom that they deserved in this country, and they now have every right that every other person of every other race has in this country.
Did they go to Niger to build black power?
Right there. Right the fuck there. If any white person had said what he did and substituted the word black for white, the video would have been taken the fuck down and the person would have been shamed as a racist for the rest of his life. But yet we let this asshole get away with it.
Did they go to Niger to clean the Flint water? Did they go to Niger to stop gentrification? Did they go to Niger to defeat poverty and build economic development for the black community? No.
No. They were down there to fight terrorism. And also, do you do any of that shit you just mentioned? Because so far, all any of us have ever seen you do is spread your racist bullshit on Facebook and divide this country even further.
So don't tell me shit about fighting for freedom. And please stop telling black people to be scared of ISIS. Because ISIS didn't dirty the Flint water. ISIS didn't create mass incarceration. ISIS didn't spray the black community with nuclear waste. Look it up, y'all. These demons is evil.
No, but ISIS kills women and children. ISIS kills anybody that doesn't believe in their bullshit ideology. ISIS would have probably thrown your ass off a rooftop after they heard your flamboyant accent.
And ISIS did not assassinate Malcolm X and Martin Luther King.
Well, of course that's true, Mr. Strawman. However, I think you need to stop bringing Martin Luther King into your freaking videos because the great Martin Luther King would be ashamed of everything that you stand for. Because you are the exact opposite of what his I Have a Dream speech was supposed to be. You don't judge anybody by the content of their character. You judge them by the color of their skin. You hate everybody that's white. The only white people you don't hate are those that bow to you and act like they owe you something. When we don't owe you shit.
Or use African bodies as guinea pigs. Yes, y'all need to Google this for real. I'm telling you the truth, girl. Google.
Oh yeah, he's telling you the truth, girl. Google. Seriously, you sit there and tell us to Google shit when you can't be bothered to even Google half the shit that you keep crapping out your ass?
And ISIS did not create an entire economic system based on the oppression of African people worldwide and colonized people worldwide.
Again, why don't you tell us how we are benefiting off the oppression of people in Africa? You keep repeating this shit and you provide no evidence or proof or even a method of how we're benefiting from that.
Okay, so black U.S. troops, I need you to know, if you have a U.S. flag or an Australian flag or a Canadian flag or any white nation's flag on your goddamn jacket and you flying around the world to oppress colonized people, you are on the wrong side. You are fighting for the oppressor against the oppressed.
Yeah, well, guess what, asshole? None of the militaries that you mentioned actually do that.
And these are the same people that will kill your These are the same people that will call you a hero today and kill your child tomorrow and call your child a criminal.
Again, name one situation where that actually happened. You're just talking at your ass.
This is what you're fighting for? This is who we're signing up to fight for? No. Hell no.
Actually, no. We're not fighting for anything that you just said. You're just talking at your ass again. We're fighting for freedom, the right to be free, and the right for you to spout your racist bullshit. So fuck off, you unappreciative jackass.
So get on the right side of history, get on the right side of the question, and join to fight for real freedom, because real freedom is fighting for black power, fighting for Africa, fighting for black people, fighting for a black future, fighting for black children, fighting for a future where no one lives at the expense of our people.
Okay, take every time he said black, change the word black to white, and then tell me what you think would happen if that was the sentence, and it was said by a white person.
Fight so nobody has to be afraid of sending their child to the grocery store to pick up Skittles and iced tea.
If you have to be afraid of that, you need to fucking move.
Fight for real freedom. Fight to forward the advancement of African people, because fighting for Jordans and a Ford Mustang, boo, ain't it. Fight that system that created poverty within the African community worldwide. Join the African People's Socialist Party.
Yeah, that's a good strategy. Fight oppression by joining a party that is nothing but oppression. Fucking dumbass.
Be a revolutionary. Go to APSPUhuru.org. And after that, after I have to say that, I don't know how you can be black and be in this military, okay? I really don't. It don't make no sense to me.
Yeah, well, a lot of us want to know how you can be a hateful, bigoted, racist piece of shit like you and still have a platform. So there's a lot of questions that we don't have answers to.
Uhuru.
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 Stop.
What?
Stop with the Uhuru.
Okay.
Anyway, that's enough out of that racist asshole. Anyway, I made this video because I find it absolutely disgusting that he is trying to use the graves of two fallen soldiers to forward his black supremacist agenda. I am equally disgusted at the fact that he has a black supremacist agenda. No race is more superior than another, and any supremacist group, whether it's white, black, Mexican, I don't care. It's disgusting, and fuck all you who think you're better than others just because of your race. We are all created equal under God, and there is no arguing that. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, please give me a like. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe, and you can catch me ripping the shit out of any assholes I find on the internet every week. But anyway, until the next video, catch y'all later.